I love that dog. I've never seen him, and I love him. He's gonna be wonderful when I meet that dog. Lots of people got lots of goddamn doggies. And you don't even have to have one to learn about doggies. Your friend might have a dog. It could be your friend's dog. He makes you him. That makes him your dog friend. You go to visit your friend, his dog is there, and you can pet him too. Hi, hello, how are you, Sneezy? You're wonderful. Hello, goddamn. And for that moment, he's your dog. So you can have someone else's dog for a while. Hi, he likes me. I think, oh my God, look at this doggy here. Goddamn doggies. Lots of things to know about them too. Lots of things you learn. You don't know where always, and you can't remember. For instance, can you remember the first time you found out that by scratching a dog here, you could make this leg go like that? And that you could make it stop when you stop. Damn. I'm in complete control of this dog. Well, that you can make their head tilt from across the room just by making a funny noise. You go, and he goes, oh, look, honey, isn't he cute? Let's get his head fixed so he stays like that. Do you ever spell in front of your dog? Some of them are smart. You got to spell. Honey, do we have any more B-O-N-E-S? B-O-N-E-S. They know the sound of B alone. B-O-N-E-S. 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 Take it easy. Take it easy. And sooner or later, what's going to happen with the little dog? Sooner or later, lying on the bed, he's going to create an incident. He's going to make one of you humans turn to the other and say, honey, did you fart?
Not me. I thought you farted.
Not me. That's not even one of my farts. I've got four farts, and that's not one of mine. I've got my Heineken's fart. I got my broccoli fart. My rice pudding fart, and my non-dairy creamer fart. And that's not one of my farts. I know. The dog farted. Tippy, why did you fart? Look at him, he knows he farted. I've seen his asshole open up. I seen it. Well, I happen to be looking at his asshole by chance. What kind of a question is that? I thought he was doing them deep breathing exercises. You see, dogs have nothing to do. There's no job description for a dog. They're forced to wait for something to happen that they can get in on. If you do something, they'll be glad to join you. But they rarely initiate any activity on their own. They're just waiting, waiting, waiting and waiting and waiting. Waiting to come in, waiting to go out, waiting to eat, waiting to crap, waiting to wake up, waiting to sleep, waiting to go upstairs, waiting to go downstairs. Sometimes they're just waiting to wait. Have you ever seen a dog just standing there? He don't know what he's waiting for. But if it happens, he'll be ready. Just a-waiting and a-waiting. Waiting for you to come home. They don't understand time. Dog doesn't know the difference between an hour and a half or next week. He thinks you're going to be gone forever. That's the only time period dogs really understand. Forever. That's how long they think everything lasts. That's how long they think everything takes. Forever and ever. Do you ever scratch your dog behind the ears? Oh boy, they love that, huh? Oh boy, you're scratching your doggy behind the ears and he really loves that. And you're looking at him and everything. And when you finally stop, he looks at you like you're a criminal. He thought it was going to go on and on and on. Same thing when you feed them. As soon as they get finished, they say, where the fuck's the food? They thought it was the loaves and the fishes. It was going to last forever and ever. Dog don't know. They must think we're going to be gone forever. Otherwise, why would they act the way they do when we finally get home? Oh boy, 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 oh boy. I thought you were never going to come home. I thought you were never going to come home. I thought you were never going to come home. I thought you were never going to come home. I didn't know what to do. You know what? I didn't know how to operate the can opener. How do you operate the can opener? I didn't know what to do, man. What do you push it down? I couldn't think of it. You know what? You know what I did? I took a can of dog food and I rolled it down the hill and hope a truck ran it over. That's what I could think of, man. They'll do that if you even just forgot your hat. You come back in 8 seconds.
Oh boy, oh boy, I thought you were never going to come home. I thought you were never going to come home. I was going to eat the bird. I couldn't find the bird. Where the fuck's the bird? And you leave the bird.
Will you stop it? I was just here. Dog don't care. He'll do whatever's next. He don't know what's next, but he'll do something. They'll do two things in a row that don't go together. You ever seen a dog walking through a room and suddenly he stops and chews his back for 18 minutes? And then when he's finished chewing, as if it were scheduled for right then, of course. And when he's finished, he doesn't even know where it was he was gonna go.
Where was I gonna go? Oh, shit. Oh, I think I'll go over here. Oh, this is nice over here. I think I'll keep coming over here.
He'll give you that doggy look. Give you them eyes, you know, to have such a great expression. Almost human. Sometimes we say that, isn't he? Look, he looks almost human, Dan.
They do, you know, they look like they know something about your mother.
They're not willing to mention it right away.
They're just looking at you like they got a trig problem they can't quite solve. There's a sad look in their eyes. All the sadness in the world is right in the eyes of a dog. Did you ever do this? Look right into your doggy's eyes and think of something really sad. And it'll look like it's happening to your dog. Strangest thing. They look at you like that. You know why they have so successful a look? Because they got eyebrows. Dogs have eyebrows. Or at least little ridges that pass for eyebrows. They got little things that they can manipulate. Just like we do. Oh, please. Please, Daddy. One more treat.
Cats can't look at you like that. Cats don't look at that. Cats look at you coldly as if they're testing new eyes. Reason cats look different, cats don't have eyebrows. Cats have a bunch of shit sticking out of their head. They thought it was going to be an eyebrow, but it didn't work out. Let's not tell them. They think it's an eyebrow. It's just a bunch of shit sticking out of their heads. Cats are cute. Cats are goddamn cute. Isn't he cute? Look at him. God, he's cute. He's a kitty cat. That's how cute they are. They needed two names. Kitty wasn't cute enough. Kitty cat. Isn't he cute? The kitty cat. Look at him. Isn't he cute? Let's drown him. You little goddamn kitty cat, ain't he? Look, stick him on the wall, see if he hangs up there. Whoa! Little goddamn kitty cat. They're so goddamn cute. Oh, they're wonderful. God love them. They're so physical. That's what's fun. They're so physical. They love to rub on you. They love to rub on you. If you've got a leg and a cat, whew, you got a party.
Oh boy, oh boy. Oh boy, oh boy. I love his leg, oh boy. I'm rubbing on his leg. Oh boy, oh boy.
If you got two legs, shit, jubilee celebration time.
Oh boy, two legs, hot shit, I can do the figure eight. They love to do the figure eight. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, I love to rub on his leg.
They'll rub against your leg even if you're not there yet. You might still be 50 feet down the hall. They see you coming.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, soon I'll be rubbing on his leg, soon.
They'll even walk sideways so they don't miss you.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy.
They love it. They're so physical. You don't have to pet a cat. You just put your hand over him and he'll do all the work, man. You pet him? You ever pet a cat who's lying absolutely flat? And before you're halfway finished, his ass is way up in the air. Like you pressed the ass button or something. Isn't he a cute little... Holy shit! How did he do that? Then they jump on your chest and put their ass right in your face. Here's my ass, Dad. Check this ass, huh? And while they're showing you their ass, they give you some of this stuff. I say, get them off of me. Jesus, I hate that. I don't even know what it is, and I don't like it. Look like they're into some bad drug. There's one other quality cats have, which I admire. Cats don't accept blame. They don't embarrass at all. Cat does something dumb, you never know it by looking at him. Dog knocks over a lamp, you can tell who did it just by looking at the dog. Not the cat. Cat doesn't accept any blame. Cat moves along to the next activity. What's that? Not me. Fuck that. I'm a cat. I'm... Something break? Ask the dog. Cat doesn't get embarrassed. You ever seen a cat race across a carpet and crash into a glass door? I meant that. That's exactly how I wanted that to look. Fucking meow. Fucking meow. Fucking meow. That's what they say when they get behind the couch. Cat's too proud to let you see him suffer. But you look behind the couch and you'll find your cat recuperating from a domestic accident. They got little slings and walkers, you know. Tried to make the window from the lamp.